Hello students, I am Dr. Sonali, an AP Biology tutor who is going to help you prepare for the AP Bio test. Today I am going to cover FRQ 4 from the very recent AP Biology 2023 test. Let's move towards our question. So the question says, non-cyclic electron flow and the cyclic electron flow, these are the two major pathways of the light dependent reaction of photosynthesis. In cyclic, non-cyclic electron flow, electron passes through photosystem 2 and then the components of electron transport chain and the photosystem 1 before finally reducing NADP plus to NADP. In cyclic electron flow, the electrons cycle through the photosystem 1 and some components of the electron transport chain. So let's try to understand the question first, what it is going to tell us. This shows a pathway where we can see there is a photolysis of water. So from here the electrons are being released, enters into the photosystem 2, then they travel through the different you can say components of the electron transport chain, and then they travel to the photosystem 1. So here there are what absorption of light happens twice, one at the photosystem 2 and second time at the photosystem 1. Right, now we know that in chlorophyll we have the structure of chlorophyll. So it has a central atom of magnesium, absorbs the light, it releases the electrons which travel through the non-cyclic cyclic pathways, and with the release of electrons we observe that these NADP, the conversion of light energy to the chemical energy takes place. Now chemical energy, when I say chemical energy, that means I am referring to NADH as well as ATP, because these are the precursors. Now these will travel to the dark reaction, isn't it? They are formed in the light reaction, they travel to the dark reaction and they will help over there in order to fix the carbon dioxide and convert it into the sugar. So that is how the whole photosynthesis system is all about. Let's talk about the question. So look at the question first. First one says, describe the role of chlorophyll in the photosystems of plant cell. So as I had just explained that what happens to the chlorophyll. So chlorophyll has a magnesium at the center which has two electrons in the outermost shell. So when it gets excited, it absorbs light, it also contributes with these two electrons which help in the further electron transportation, isn't it? So what are we trying to say, that the chlorophyll is a major light absorption pigment which helps in the electron transport through the different photosystems. Let's talk about the second part of the question. Based on figure 1, explain why an increase in the ratio of NADPH to NADP plus will cause an increase in the flow of electrons through the cyclic pathway. Let's go back to the cycle. So here, as we understand, what is happening when this NADP positive getting converted into NADPH. So now it is, the question says, increase in ratio of NADPH to NADP positive will cause an increase in the flow of electron through the cyclic pathway. So here what happens when this conversion take place, when NADPH will keep on forming, what will happen? As a result, this NADP's concentration will reduce, right? Since in the cyclic pathway, when NADP is reducing, what will happen? This NADPH will, whatever electrons are being released, they will move towards which pathway? Since cyclic pathway is not possible now because of the absence or less concentration of NADP positive, so the electron flow will increase towards the non-cyclic pathway. So that's the explanation to the part B. Now let's come to the part C. Using rice plants, scientists examined the effect of mutation that result in the loss of this protein CRR6. It is a part of photosystem 1, and its absence reduces the activity of photosystem 1. What does photosystem 1 do? That we have to see. So you have to predict the effect of mutation on the rate of biomass accumulation. Now let's move towards the concept of mutation. Mutation is basically whenever there is an error caused, the protein won't be able to form, and that affects the efficiency of particular system. So that is how photosystem 1 will not work properly. As a result, what will happen? Whatever the chemical components we are forming, like NADH, and in addition to that, we can refer NADH or NADPH, right? So these are basically nothing but the electron acceptors. So we can, since in the question NADPH is given, so we'll write NADPH only. NADPH and ATP synthesis will take place through these photosystems. So when this protein is mutated, the photosystem 1 is not functioning properly, these chemical compounds won't be formed properly. And see what happens, as I had mentioned earlier also, that these components, they enter to the Kelvin cycle, and in the Kelvin cycle, carbon dioxide, atmospheric carbon dioxide, is fixed into G3P and then sugar molecule, right? So now, since these are less because of inefficient photosystem 1, so their inflow to the Kelvin cycle will also be minimized, reduced. As a result, this accumulation, this conversion of carbon dioxide to sugar will also get affected. So that's what the you can say the impact, and that is the prediction, or that is the reason behind that.
Thank you so much for watching my video. If you have liked this explanation, please subscribe to my channel so that you will get an update whenever I'll upload any FRQ explanation or review material for the AP Biology exams. So stay tuned in the future as well. Thank you so much.